Our goal is really to help raise awareness and identify the many, many solutions that need to come together in order to impact change on housing affordability, and we represent one of those things. There's nothing more literal growing up in New York City than brick and mortar. And so I actually spent the last 7 years, 8 years building buildings and managing residential rental properties, really understanding it as a business and as the social good and need of providing housing for people is really, in hindsight, part of the mashup of what makes Rhino Rhino. Rhino came from the idea of really focusing on breaking down barriers. We provide an insurance program that reduces the upfront cost of housing by replacing a cash security deposit with a really cheap insurance policy. The way we propose to people to think about an idea so differently, really starting with the simplest form of just what a cash security deposit does. It protects an owner or property manager from something that may or may not happen in the future. If you think about that statement, that's really what insurance is by definition. Whatever life stage you're in, we want to be there to support you with Rhino.
My apartment is in the Ditmas Park section of Brooklyn. When it comes to security deposits that you have to put down when finding somewhere new, it can be really extremely hard. Like when I moved here, I had $0, zero savings, and had we not found Rhino, I would have moved back to Philadelphia because there was no option for me. For a lot of people, it's not just something that gets in the way, it can be what entirely separates you from finding your home in a new city.
When I hear statistics like 40% of Americans don't have $400 saved for an emergency. That's not for next month's rent, that's for an emergency. That's shocking.
When we ask for these tremendously high upfront move-in costs, we're asking people to lock up 3 or 4 or 5 times their life savings.
We pay like a really low monthly fee, smaller than my Spotify bill. So it's kind of easy to forget that it's even there. It really had just made all of the fears of finding a new place, it mitigated a lot of that for me.
We're about 55 people today based in New York City, in the Flatiron District, just around the corner. We have offices in Los Angeles and Dallas that are expanding.
I would describe Rhino's culture and team as dynamic but focused. Everyone's job impacts the mission and how much everyone feels that.
At Rhino, we think about housing affordability as one of the central issues facing the world today. It really is as important of a building block of society as things like healthcare, education.
Last fall at Rhino, we put out a public policy proposal. We called it the Renter Choice and Flexibility Plan. And the goal of that was to really stimulate conversation and dialogue. The Renter's Choice legislation that the city of Cincinnati, Ohio passed is an opportunity for legislative bodies to act and deliver opportunity to renters.
When a normal person thinks about startups and technology, it tends to be just about money, right? Making money and creating some outsized amount of wealth. I think I've very intentionally set our ambition considerably above that, which is not just about creating wealth, but actually also creating a really moralistic impact on society.